Welcome back to News Sources. Now, former Prime Minister Raila Odinga appears to be the glue that holds politics together. The ODM leader has lately been subject to Jubilee attacks and abuses where he's being accused of causing some voter apathy, apparently, in central Kenya. Meanwhile, his supposed friends in opposition are busy asking him to stand down and support them in their quest for presidency. Oh, what does Raila have? What was his problem?
No, you see, once you're in the government, you are supposed to perform. Once we elect you and you go to the government, we expect you to perform. Now, any moment you don't perform, you give Raila Odinga the chance to come, to just spot on that. Now, about voter apathy in Central, voter apathy means what? That the people are deciding that they'll not vote for Uhuru Kenyatta and Jubilee. I don't think that's the case. I don't think Raila has something to do with that. The apathy, if any, would be because of what the Jubilee government has not done for the people of Central. Not much about what Raila is asking the people to do. And you see, we are in a country where everybody can see. We can all see, we can all hear. Nobody, right now, my auntie at the village can tell what is happening in this country better than I could when I was in those years, okay? Anybody can see. If there is any voter apathy, it is going to be caused, first of all, by the splits within the Jubilee Party itself, and also by what the Jubilee has not done for the people. For having promised to do it and having failed. Otherwise, the apathy, if you are talking about Central Kenya, Raila Odinga has nothing to do with that. Really.
I think Raila's name is always used to get people to vote. It was used the same way. There is the fear that is always created about Raila is so that guys come out to vote so that he doesn't win. It's not to vote so that we can do something for the country. It's always about let us vote so that we stop him from coming in. And that is the same. The voter apathy tag is being used so that people don't get so worked up that they fail to vote for Jubilee Party in the next election, especially in Central Kenya. It's not that they are not going to vote. It's created so that you know it's like you must vote so that the other guy doesn't come in.
I think I repeat it again. Jubilee will be judged not on what Raila says or does. It's what they have delivered for 4 years. They had time to deliver. They had good promises for Kenyans, including those in Gatundu, where Uhuru Kenyatta comes from. But he hasn't delivered. So if you say apathy because of Raila, even those busybodies who hold press conferences in town, every time Raila speaks, they respond. It's like a robot responding. They know their party has not delivered, even in their own constituencies. Like Duale in his own constituency, citizens don't have IDs. They are fighting, looking for an ID, an identity card. That's part of a government function, which they're in government, they have not delivered. It's not Raila to be blamed for that.
But going to Raila as a person, okay? The gentleman has a way of carrying himself. You must give credit to that. It's always said that if Raila tells you it was raining yesterday, for sure, even if you didn't see the rain, it was there. He has networks. You see, this is a man who has been in politics for quite a long time. Okay, he has networks. He has been in government and out. And he has been in KANU government and out. He has been in Kibaki government and out. He knows how to get what he wants, the information he wants. So that even when he says something, even if he is sure wrong, it will be carried on as a debate for another 1 or 2 weeks. Before we prove that he was wrong, we will have debated him for quite a while. And by that time, he'll come out up with another item, and we will pick that and drop this one. So that is the work of a politician. And people say now that he has enough time for that. And as we head towards an election with a government that is always shaky, once it's shaken a little bit, they run, you know, they jump all over. In fact, I was asking the other day why they keep traveling, both of them together. That is one way of detecting a weak administration. So that he is able to hammer them, he is able to do it once again, and he'll continue doing it as we have.
Let's flip this to his, you know, this is, you know, early this week when former vice president formally got his NDC to say, well, you can now go forth and, you know, run for the presidency. And we've had these cries from inside his own supposed friends saying, now we should retire, you know, give us the backing and leave it for us.
I think the fear is always that you know, even in the opposition, it's an open fact that Raila has the highest number of votes countrywide. The fear is if he doesn't back you up, means you don't get this high number of votes.
But that has never been proved. So it's
but he has across. He's out of this whole team. He's the one who is at least more cross-cutting compared to the rest. If you deal with Kalonzo, it's more of Ukambani. If you deal with Wetangula, it's more Western. When you deal with Raul,
it's in Western.
But, but this notion of Niachie
exactly.
is wrong.
Niachie, right? Yes.
Because these guys are contesting and competing. Whoever attracts more people, whoever is more popular, let him get the ticket. That should be the issue here. That's
exactly. Democracy. You know, you can't compete with the
You
Raila.
Can't say it's that Raila should be.
Democracy would dictate that. Let them go to their party elections.
Yes.
Their coalition elections.
A coalition election.
The man who has the votes there.
Let the other day
I saw some Luya polling of who is more popular in the Luya community. I saw it. It was being conducted the other day. And they all decided on whoever they decided. Let it happen also in court. Let them do their internal elections
right.
and come out with a candidate.
Okay.
That's the way forward.
Let's take with it. And also our President Uhuru Kenyatta today reopened Webuye Pan Paper Mills in what his spokesman says is a move that will return thousands of jobs in the sleepy town of Webuye. The political translation for that is that the people of Western should now reciprocate and vote for Uhuru Kenyatta. It is not lost on observers that key Western Kenya leaders kept away the president's tour. All right.
I think this Webuye Pan Paper, it's now called Rai, I think Pan Paper Factory. It's a private company anyway. It's not a public company. And it's employing around 300 people. So to tell us that it's there to give Western people jobs is a lie. It's just trying to enrich his fellow businessmen. And again, he has not declared his interest in the company. So
In 2010, yes. President Mwai Kibaki reopened.
Exactly. I was just about to say that. It's time for that. The president is working. He has the right to open and reopen anything. It's jubilee time.
I think it's not working. It's not political trail, a campaign trail.
Let me finish that. Yeah. Say, he is working in whichever way he thinks, whether he wants to open Pan Paper, or whether he wants to open another company or any other project. It's his time. The only thing I can say is that anything you see being done at this point in time, whether it is to open a road or anything, it is geared towards the elections. You must see it in that context. You must not lose that sight. You see, in some sectors like coffee, there has been the reforms after reforms. We reform the coffee sector every other year. We have it has been reformed and re-reformed. Kibaki did it all through, even during Moi's time. Whenever he wanted votes in Central, it was all about reforming the coffee sector. It's exactly the same thing these guys are doing. And once you elect them, then they'll hold it. They'll put a hold. Then they can be able to do it once again. For purposes of 2022, you'll see that same factory being reopened.
This factory will be reopened until the year 2000.
It will be reopened so many times. Remember, I think one thing that has jolted Uhuru and Ruto to start opening and reopening projects
and
is because of the insecurity that has been caused by Raila and the corruption scandals. There's a time I think Raila was mentioning a corruption scandal. I think nearly every 2 days. That has created a scenario where most people are now a bit have issues with Uhuru and Ruto and how they're handling and how they have delivered. So many, even in his own central background, there are some murmurs about what he's doing and how he's handling all these things. That has jolted them to start walking around. Remember, they started with the Central, Rift Valley, Ukambani to launch projects. Some of them are said to have been launched before. Politics is about perception.
Exactly.
So they go to what touches the hearts of local residents, then show that we are opening it. Then, you know, when you touch the hearts, means it's supposed to translate to votes. That is the main intention.
But which hearts are you touching? sometimes we underrate the public and think they're very stupid. Because when you go, for instance, it's been Western commissioning or relaunching roads. Some roads are owned by, they fall under county government. But he's there, launching them, or relaunching them, and telling us that's the development is bringing to people. In Ukambani, when he was there, we heard that there were caterpillars on the way, but when he left, they also left the site. Do the public still don't see that the caterpillars have left the site?
Exactly, they don't see. You see, if you are talking about the public can be deceived in any one way. If it means entering a small hut and putting electricity there, knowing very well that even the house itself may not survive, the house itself, that's part of the campaign. And what people see and feel is what wins them. If he is able to launch, there are so many people now who believe that the company he was opening today is their lifeline. It's going to they are going to carry on from there.
Yes. Okay? Yes.
Even if they come and open it again next year, they'll still believe the same thing.
All right. Finally, the government this week insists that their money is streaming from foreigners to influence the upcoming elections. President Uhuru Kenyatta says the cash is coming through as a disguise for civic education, while all the while it is meant for saboteurs. Is there really anything like this, or it's panic time?
Muzi ni wa wananchi wetu. Hatutaki tuingiliwe na inchi zingine wakituambia wanatusomesha sijui civic education ati njisi ya kupi. Wakenya wanajua kupiga kura. Mukitaka kutusaidia, help the organizations, IEBC and other institutions, help them. Sio hii magrupu ingine inazunguka zunguka huko na mambo ya ukora. Hiyo hatutaki.
I find it very difficult.
He said help the IEBC and other organizations. Na sio hizo zingine za wakora, something like that. So I don't know which are these other organizations. And I don't know what he meant by help the IEBC, because civic education, you give support to IEBC to conduct civic education. But he has already said, Wakenya wanajua kupiga kura.
So we don't need civic education.
Even the IEBC, what is it supposed, what kind of education is it supposed to conduct then? But the point he is missing is that civic education is education like any other. It's a right, okay? You can't stop civic education. What you can do is that if you know that there is any organization that is subverting, you know, it's conducting itself in a manner likely to show that it's not for the, it has ill will for the public of Kenya, then that's the organization to deal with, okay? And you can investigate it. You can do a manner of things towards that. But when you're talking about conducting civic education, teaching people, voting is not just putting the paper in the box is not what voting is about. I think that if you test this country, you realize that very many people do not even know the reasons as to why they vote. Very many people still believe an MP is supposed to come and build roads and build dams and all manner of things, okay? What they don't know is that an MP has only three roles that are defined very clearly in the Constitution. And the MPs themselves would not want those three roles to be reflected, because they know what to have on Hapasana. They want to engage in what an MCA does in the villages. Most of the MPs do what actual MCAs are supposed to do right now.
I think if the president has handlers, and the handlers, he listens to his handlers, they should make sure it doesn't look like he's panicking in public. That is one of the comments that makes it look as if he's panicking about guys being educated about how to vote, because there's no foreign organization or foreign funded organization that will come and make you vote for a certain party if you don't want to. You'll only be told, you're only educated on how to choose wisely or how to make the right decisions or how to vote and all that. Remember, majority of our electorate is, sorry to say, but illiterate, because even today I think there was some report that was launched by Uwezo that says 8% of class 8s cannot do work set aside for class 3 pupils. Now remember, these are the same people who grew up to be voters. If you don't carry out civic education, how else will you help them to vote wisely?
I think what I picked out from him, one, is a president who has run out of ideas on how to govern. Secondly, I think he wants to deal with an informed public, those ones who don't know anything, those ones who can be told, lied around, and they buy ideas. Thirdly, I think is just ironical. The same government, key critical sectors, say education, security, are funded by foreigners or foreign or donor funds. So if he's saying, let's cut those funding, we start by his own government.
Because and after all, he has access to all the agencies. Yes. If they are illegal
and
things being done
bank.
By NGOs, you
the,
can easily access
the central bank that monitors it, yes. money inflows.
True. All right, so I asked you on Twitter if you think Jubilee can conduct free and fair party elections. I got some tweets here. Eric Tanui says, of course, yes. Those few counties have overshadowed the other counties who have conducted theirs peacefully. Ndego Asidakwa on Twitter says, free and fair elections in Kenya is something that will evade us for a long period of time, not only for Jubilee, but even Code. Finally, yes, Jubilee can conduct fair elections if they involve the party members in a bottom-up approach. And 68% of you think absolutely not, 32% of you think yes. That's how we finish News Sources tonight. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your tweets. I'll be reading them and retweeting some of that. Coming up, KTN News. Thank you very much, panel, for coming tonight. That's News Sources for tonight.